Fringe-toed lizard is listed as endangered by the state of California. It's listed as threatened by the federal government. And some of the problems with the fringe-toed lizard, in the 1980s, it was habitat. Development was occurring over the dunes, and so that's why this reserve was put in place. The lizard requires moving sand, active dunes. Okay, so these dunes are constantly moving, and the sand is actually blowing. It's called a fringe-toed lizard because it has fringes on its toes that act like snowshoes, or in this case, sand shoes, so that the lizard can run on top of the blow sand very easily.
This is one of the hottest, driest deserts in North America. And everywhere you look on every other side, there's nothing but dry desert, whereas you have over here, you have this gorgeous oasis. Always see the tracks that head out towards the water. We have coyotes, lots of coyotes. That's one of our top predators out here. We also have bobcats. We have bobcats in almost every grove. We also have the gray horned owl, which we call the tiger of the night.
This plant right here is a honey mesquite, a native mesquite for the area. And it has thorns on it, so I'm not gonna jump into it. This over here is a mistletoe, similar to the kind that you kiss under. It's a desert mistletoe, but a similar species to the coastal mistletoe.
This is the heart of the preserve. All of the trails start from the Palm Log Cabin. It is the hub of the Coachella Valley Preserve, which is a cooperative effort between CNLM and our partners with the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service, the California Department of Fish and Wildlife, the California Department of Parks and Recreation, and a number of other members of this community.
Hi, my name is Felicia Sercha, and I work for the United States Fish and Wildlife Service in our Palm Springs Fish and Wildlife Office. Our main mission is to ensure the conservation and recovery of species that are on the federal list of endangered species. I have a love for reptiles, and so here in Coachella Valley, we have an endangered reptile.
Doing lizard monitoring is an interesting and fun experience because they're really interesting animals to watch, partly because they are so fast. One of the ways that we actually monitor them is by watching for their footprints. It will see you and it will take off like a shot. Boom, across the dunes, and you just see this little, all you see is this like blur across the dunes, and you can see the sand flying as its little fringe-toed feet, you know, hit the sand dunes. Those babies go fast, and they go so fast, and then all of a sudden they disappear, and it will instantaneously bury itself into the sand when it's threatened, so it will hide itself under the sand within a matter of seconds, and you will not be able to see it.
We couldn't do the conservation and recovery work that we do without organizations like the Center for Natural Lands Management. They have been key in the valley in acquiring and managing native habitats that support not only the fringe-toed lizard, but also desert pupfish and threatened and endangered migratory birds.
We'd love to encourage the public to volunteer their time to come out here. There's a lot of work that volunteers can do, such as pulling invasive weeds on the dunes, or trail maintenance, fence maintenance, things like that. Even some of the ponds here need to have cattails removed periodically. And so those are things that volunteers can do out here.
We hope you've enjoyed some of our inspiring rescue stories. Please join our community and help us in our ongoing preservation efforts by visiting us at cnlm.org.